Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us here today for this update on COVID-19 variants circulating here in the state of Hawaii. The Department of Health State Laboratories Division has been working with private sector labs to collect and examine specimens of the virus that caused COVID-19. And we've been doing this for a number of months now. It's part of our disease surveillance system. Earlier this week, we had reported that the L452R variant was present in 9 samples here in the islands. And we also reported that whole genome sequencing was being performed on 4 specimens containing a molecular clue to determine whether the B117 variant is here in the islands. This is the variant that is commonly referred to as the UK variant because it was first detected in the United Kingdom. And the results are in, and for the first time, we can confirm that this highly transmissible variant has been detected here in the islands. Lieutenant Governor Josh Green will be giving an update on this during this press conference. And we do have Dr. Edward Desmond, who would provide specific information on the variants, and Dr. Sarah Kemble, who will be providing information about the state's contact tracing activities and what we do and what we are doing to continue to keep our community safe. The good news is that we know how to slow the spread, and we've proven that we can be successful by taking these simple measures: mask, watch your distance, wash your hands, and stay home when you're sick. You know, these actions will continue to help deter the spread of COVID-19 here in the island. I do want to thank everyone here in Hawaii who has taken the virus seriously, and we've made good progress. We are seeing lower case counts and hospitalizations, and Dr. Green will be providing that detailed information. We are getting people vaccinated as soon as the doses are received here in the islands. But we do want to emphasize that the B117 variant is different. As we've seen in the United Kingdom, it can swiftly spread and erase all progress that we've made here in the state. But we do know how to stop this and other variants. We know what actions and precautions we need to take in order to slow the spread. And I would just remind you to please do not attend in-person Super Bowl parties this weekend. That can be a super spreader event. Clearly, unless you intend not to eat or drink or talk with people, you know, Super Bowl can be enjoyed within your family unit. We want to remind you to limit gatherings to household members only. Continue to mask, wash your hands, watch the distance, and stay home when you're sick. I mean, all of these actions we know help deter the spread of this virus. And then finally, get vaccinated when it's your turn. We are not helpless in fighting this variant or the spread of COVID-19. We can do these simple things and take action to slow the spread of COVID-19. Thank you.
Thanks, Governor. Lieutenant Governor Josh Green is our next speaker.
Aloha. Thank you for having me, Gov. So welcome everybody to this press conference. While we are worried that there is a B117 case here, and that is what Gov just described, the B117 variant, also referred to as UK, we're concerned because it's more infectious. It's up to 60% more infectious, and that research is ongoing. We'll get more technical description from Dr. Desmond and Dr. Kemble, but it is something that, as the government pointed out, can spread more aggressively. So we're going to have to be careful. In our conversation just moments before we came out, Dr. Desmond said a very astute thing to the governor and I. He said, this is what you have to deal with. You have the virus and how that spreads. You have your behavior, and then you have the vaccinations. And the vaccinations that we are giving do work against the B.1.1.7 variant. So we want to reassure people of that. We, though, have to follow what the governor said, and that is be in control of what we can control, and that's our behavior. Wearing masks, socially distancing, not double dipping our chips at the Super Bowl party, which we shouldn't be having. These are the things that we can control. Now, there is some good news and for perspective, so people don't panic, and you shouldn't panic. This is where we were a month ago. On January 5th, our 7-day average case count was 139.6 new cases daily. We had 3.48% positivity rate, and we had 105 people in the hospital at the time. So we had pretty high numbers. This was coming off of the New Year's and Christmas surge, if I'm not mistaken, Gov. So that occurred, and you know, we were mindful that that was going to be a challenge, and we went through it, came through it as a family and a state, and did fine. Took some time to come down off of that. And here we are on February 5th with much lower numbers. 85.1 new cases daily on average the last 7 days, a 1.83% positivity rate, way lower, and 57 individuals in the hospital with COVID, very few in the intensive care unit. Now, I point out this number of 1.83% positivity rate because that suggests there's not been a lot of spread right now because you guys have been doing such a great job keeping masked up, not going to big gatherings with some exceptions, staying socially distant. That's very important. So keep this in mind as we look at what we're dealing with now, which is the B.1.1.7 variant, which could spread more quickly if we don't do well. How can we control this? Well, the Gov pointed out one of our weapons is vaccinations, and we've given 189,446 shots as of yesterday. Excellent work from Libby and her team, Director Char, General Hara and his team, and so many across our state at hospitals, our partners at Pier 2, that's HPH, Queens over at the Blaisdell, so many people doing great work. A lot of vaccines. That's about 50,000 doses on average now per week. We've done more than 10,000 a day on several occasions. And so this is something that we can control, and we need to control that in addition to our behavior. By March 1st, we're targeting about 350,000 shots being done, and April 1st, 550,000 shots. So we are, in a way, a race against time to protect our kupuna and all of our people in the state. This is the way we defeat COVID. But it also will come down to how we handle ourselves this next weekend. Now, you all know that Tom Brady's going to throw 15 touchdown passes, win his 30th Super Bowl. It's probably not worth watching in a big gang and drinking a lot of beer. So please don't spread COVID this weekend. If you are at a gathering, in spite of what we've asked, to watch beautiful Tom Brady beat us all, please wear your mask. Don't drink too much. Don't get in people's faces. And make sure that we don't spread this variant or any other variant of COVID for the next few days. Aloha.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor. Our next speaker is Dr. Edward Desmond, DOH, Director of the State Laboratories Division.
Thank you. We feel lucky that we have the tool that's needed at the moment, which is DNA sequencing. We can do whole genome sequencing. It's a tool we've had for several years. And in the past, we have used this to track spread of other infectious diseases and antibiotic resistance. Now, in this case, we're able to do whole genome sequencing, analyze the genetic material of the virus completely in about a week. If our lab works very hard, works evenings and weekends, which they have been doing, thank you very much to the lab staff for that. And this is really only pertinent if it's part of a system, and we work with the state epidemiologist, disease outbreak control division, so they help us collect the specimens that are most likely to have viruses that have variants. And we collect them also from all parts of the state to make sure that we don't miss it in any of the neighbor islands and so forth. So as I mentioned, it takes about a week, and we create a large data set. We report when variants are present to Doc D, state epidemiologist, and then they are able to implement the control measures, the contact investigation. So we feel very important to be part of this system, and we hope that following the measures which the governor and lieutenant governor have described, that maybe we can keep this under control until we're all vaccinated, because the vaccine seems to work quite well against this new UK B.1.1.7 variant. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Desmond. And finally, we have Dr. Sarah Kemble, Acting State Epidemiologist, DOH.
Thank you. So I want to pick up from where Dr. Desmond left off, the handoff from the State Laboratories Division to Disease Outbreak Control Division. This relationship is really important. So we get information from the lab as soon as they have detected any strain of concern, and that goes straight to our case investigation and contact tracing teams. So we are right away investigating those cases actively, identifying contacts, and making sure that cases are in isolation and contacts are in quarantine. And we're also providing monitoring to make sure that we aren't seeing health effects in these strain-related cases that are different from what we've seen before. I think the important thing is that we can learn from these strains and understand how broadly they are spreading, if they are spreading, and if they are spreading, understand why. So that's really the case investigation piece. The core message really is just as the governor and lieutenant governor were saying, the tools to combat these strains are the same that we have learned and are already practicing. So it's really about watching your distance, washing your hands, wearing your mask, and staying home when you're sick. And if we can all do those things, we can continue to combat COVID-19, even in the face of some of these new variant strains, and get your vaccine when your turn comes. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Kemble. And with that, we'll open it up to questions from our local reporters. Please raise your hands virtually, and we'll call on you for questions. First up is Kristen Concilio, Star Advertiser. Kristen, go ahead.
Dr. Desmond, how many cases of this B117 strain? Is it in all four of the samples, and from what islands, and how long do you think it's been in Hawaii?
We're now performing sequencing on four strains. And how long has it been in the state? I really don't know, but I do know, which I learned from the Disease Outbreak Control Division, that a couple of the suspected cases do not have a travel history. We've only really confirmed one case as of now. We'll have another final result later this afternoon, another one tomorrow. So that's all the information I have right now.
Thank you very much, Dr. Desmond. Any other questions from reporters standing by? I see Eleni. Eleni Avendano, Civil Beat. Go ahead.
Aloha. I was wondering if this patient had a travel history.
The B117 variant strain case that has been identified did not have any history of travel. So that indicates that, you know, that came from somewhere in the community. I think we're now seeing this variant, and I believe over 33, it may be more as of today, other U.S. states. And as that spreads through the continental United States, ultimately those strains reach us here as well, just by virtue of, you know, people moving and traveling. So I think that there is some community transmission, although albeit small right now. We haven't detected a lot of these cases, and we've been looking, but it is an indicator that these strains will become part of what circulates in the islands with time.
Thank you, Dr. Kemble. Reporters, we ask that you let us know who your question is for before asking your question. With that, Jolani Martinez, this is Hawaii News Now. Go ahead. Jelani, can you unmute?
My question is for Lieutenant Governor Green.
Go ahead, Jelani. Jelani,
Lieutenant Governor, we wanted to know, with the numbers close to meeting Tier 3 standards, could we see Oahu soon moving up to Tier 3?
Great. Thank you for the question. Obviously, this is a decision that the governor will make with Mayor Blangiardi. The good news has been our numbers have been much lower, but we're really mindful of risk right now because we are, in many ways, turning the corner on COVID because we've been vaccinating a lot of individuals with the Department of Health and all of our partners. Each week that passes, we're getting that much closer to a safe circumstance. And I think that it's fair to say that the mayor and governor and all of our leadership are really considering these three things: which viruses are here, how much we're able to control it — that's been good news because you guys have done such a great job keeping the numbers down — and then finally how much vaccine we're getting into people's arms. So I think it would be more fair for us to leave that question probably to Mayor Blangiardi when he makes recommendations to the Gov. And I wanted to make one more clarification from a previous question. I believe that this particular case, that's the B117, was on Oahu, correct? Yes, someone had asked that. So we will keep checking for these variants, and Dr. Desmond's team and Dr. Kemble, they've been able to have a good surveying program. I think they do about 75 surveys a week, 300 a month. So they're getting a good breadth of safety net check for us in Hawaii.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor. Ashley Mizuo, Hawaii Public Radio. Ash.
I think this is going to be for Dr. For maybe Lieutenant Governor Green, or can you talk about how this new variant is going to affect herd immunity and the need to scale up on taking the vaccine, and also what that'll mean for maybe the communications with DOH going forward, trying to get more people to get vaccinated?
That's a very good question. That was my first thought when I heard that there was a case, not a lot of cases, but a case of the B117 variant. I figured people's immediate response would be concern or fear. They shouldn't be afraid. We don't feel that we know it right now that it's more lethal or anything. We'll continue to study that, but we will wait and see on that. But it will spread more quickly. And for those who believe in being vaccinated — we leave this to people to make up their own minds — we know that this will incent people to go and get the vaccine when their time comes. About 50% of us in Hawaii right off the bat said we would get vaccinated. We were polling and asking people. Another 25% of us said probably when we go through the Coconut Wireless and we hear about the vaccine, if it's safe — it's been very safe. And then another quarter of our population, maybe not so much. But I'll tell you this, this variant will catch on. That's what variants do. It will spread if we don't do a good job with masks. And so please consider very strongly getting vaccinated so that we can stop the COVID crisis. It will spread more aggressively with this variant like it is in other states. So our vaccine will stop it. We're definitely going to be continuously redoubling our commitment to vaccinations for the state.
Thank you very much, Lieutenant Governor. Next up is Nikki Shenfield, KHON2. Nikki?
I think this will be for Dr. Kemble or LG, but has close contacts been tested of the case on Oahu?
Yes, there is one close contact who's actually also a positive case, which is currently being sequenced as well. I anticipate likely that would also be a B117 given the epidemiology. But we will see what the final sequencing shows on that. The other close contacts have been investigated, tested so far negative, so that contact tracing investigation is ongoing.
Thank you very much, Dr. Kemble. Kristen Concilio, Star Advertiser. Kristen?
Dr. Kemble, you previously said with new variants, the state would need to vaccinate 80 to 90% instead of 60 to 70% of the population in order to achieve herd immunity. Do you think that's realistic? And how do you plan to do that?
We don't know yet exactly what level we're gonna need to reach for herd immunity, even with these novel variant strains, but we do know it's likely to be a higher vaccine coverage that's needed to get that tipping point where we break transmission through vaccination in the community. So it's really about redoubling our efforts, making sure that we are getting vaccine out and that people are coming to get the vaccine when it's their turn. I'm sorry, was there another part to your question?
Kristen, did she answer your question completely?
Well, I just want to know, are you gonna make, I guess, increase efforts to encourage people to get vaccinated or have a you know, increase your public awareness campaign, or what, is there any plan in place?
I think this just underscores the importance of getting out the vaccine and getting out the people to come get shots in arms.
Thank you very much, Dr. Campbell. Any other questions, reporters? Okay, Jolani. Go ahead.
My question is for Dr. Campbell.
Go ahead.
Is there a do you folks have a different close contact definition with variant cases?
The definition of close contacts doesn't change for a variant case. The way that the virus transmits is not different. And I think this is important. It's not that it is more airborne or transmit in a different mechanism. It's really more about the variant has been shown to have higher viral loads in those who are infected, and it has to do with some of the mutations in the spike protein, which is the protein that mediates entry of the virus into cells. And so it allows the virus to take a stronger hold once you are infected and perhaps then have a heavier shedding burden. And that's what makes it more infectious to other people. So it doesn't change what you need to do to prevent transmission. It's still masking, it's still the 6-foot distancing, and it's still washing your hands.
Thank you very much, Doctor. Eleni Avendano, Civil Beat, go ahead.
This question is for Dr. Desmond and Dr. Campbell. Is there any plan to increase surveillance sampling from 75 specimens per week? And if not at this time, why?
Dr. Desmond and I are reviewing the surveillance sampling continuously, and I'll let him speak to that as well. Right now, the 300 samples a month has yielded what we hoped, which is to capture these variants and allow us to calculate a proportion. And so right now it's doing what we want it to do, but we will of course be reevaluating that as we go and making sure that we have an adequate sample to answer the questions that we need to answer.
Thank you, Dr. Kimball. Dr. Desmond, did you have anything to add?
No, I have nothing to add to that.
Okay, great. Thank you. Reporters on either. Okay, Eleni, go ahead.
Another question for Lieutenant Governor Green. How are hospitals preparing for this in light of the fact that transmissibility is heightened with B117?
Thank you for that question. Hospitals are preparing the way they have been preparing before, which is for the unknown. They've already got plans in place to augment their beds and capacity if needed, although our beds are at a very low level right now in use. As you remember, somewhere around August 26th or 27th, we reached about 318 cases of COVID in our hospitals, and today we're sitting at 56. So we're ready. Another important part of the preparation has actually been phase 1A of the vaccination plan, and that was to actually vaccinate healthcare workers as a part of the initial rollout of vaccinations, along with our kupuna who lived at nursing homes. So the first 180,000 doses or so have gone, I'll remind people, to the healthcare community so that they don't get sick in case of a variant like this, which they will be protected by the vaccine, so that we don't have outbreaks at our long-term care facilities where our kupuna are most vulnerable. And then finally, our top priority in the 1B category, which was individuals 75 and older. So the work that the governor advised us to do was to limit the risk to our most vulnerable people so we don't get hospitalizations. Those who catch the regular variant of COVID-19 or the B117 variant, if people catch that, will hopefully be younger people and not as likely to need hospitalization. We do always prepare to have extra shifts and extra personnel available if necessary. We're hopeful that we won't get a big surge. We're hopeful that our vaccination plan will outstrip the pace of any of the variants of COVID.
Thank you very much, Lieutenant Governor. Nikki Shenfield, KHON2, go ahead.
And sorry, I just wanted to clarify. I know that the case and the close contact was on Oahu, but where was the other pending variant strain? Was that on a different island or still here on Oahu? Sorry for any of the doctors.
All of the S1 target dropouts, these strains with a molecular clue, that's what clues us in to look for the B117 strain. So all of those samples that we've received and are currently working on sequencing with the lab are Oahu specimens.
All right, any other questions? OK, Okay, Eleni, go ahead, Eleni.
Aloha, thank you. How much lead time does the health department have now in terms of knowing what allocation the islands will be receiving, Dr. Kimball?
So with partnership from the federal government, we are now getting about a 2 to 3 week projection for what we can expect in terms of allocations. So that's been helpful to have that increased communication. We do understand it's still just a projection, and so we have to wait to see what the allocation actually is. But that does help us with planning.
Thank you very much, Dr. Kimball. Anyone else? Any other questions? Okay. With that, Governor, do you have any closing remarks?
Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. We just wanted to make sure and be transparent in informing all of you as soon as we had confirmed that we did get a case with the B117 variant that originated or was first identified in the United Kingdom. It is a testament to our surveillance system and the work that the State Department of Health Laboratory Division and the Disease Investigation Division has in working with the private sector, the labs and the physicians in the state to create a surveillance network that allows us to identify these variants. So just want to assure you that we continue to act in the best interest of all of you to keep you healthy and safe. We wanted to make sure that you were aware that we found the first case of the variant. And I think most importantly, wanted to remind all of us that we know what it takes to slow the spread of COVID-19 here in the islands. It is about wearing your mask, washing your hands, watching your distance, staying home when you're sick, and then certainly getting vaccinated when your turn. So again, I encourage you not to attend in-person Super Bowl parties this weekend. We know that there is great fan interest in the game, but doing your part means to watch the game and celebrate within your family unit. And if we can all make this sacrifice this weekend, it will help us in the fight against COVID-19. So thank you very much. Remember, wear your mask, wash your hands, watch your distance, and get vaccinated. Aloha. Mm-hmm.